we're talking many different groups that this affects, and I think technology is not helping. It is and it isn't, but it really isn't helping.
It covers all demographics, young and old, urban and rural, rich and poor, all ethnicities. Like, for example, we were really surprised at the amount of submissions we got from young people. And there's one submission there, it's just very brief, from a student, and it's in the back of the report. And it says, I'm in college in Queens, Belfast, and I'm finding it very hard, not from an academic point of view, but just meeting people and that. It's Monday afternoon, and I realise I've spoken to nobody since last Thursday, and I interact with the world via Twitter and Instagram. I train every day, and I run 4 times a week. I'm lonely. There you go. I finally said it. But that's unbelievable. That's really powerful. That's powerful stuff. And it's, you know, by all metrics, we're like a healthy, wealthy country. But you'd wonder sometimes, you know, in this most interconnected Twitter and Instagram and Snapchat, you know, the people are as lonely as this, and really personal contact and human interaction can't be superseded by technology, and I think it's important to get that message across.
It's funny, there are so many groups that you can see loneliness being a huge problem with, as I said, kind of grown older in Ireland. And I remember last year I was up in Letterkenny and I visited one of these Good Morning services, where they ring up maybe somebody who's elderly and they say, good morning, how are you? And they catch up and they know about maybe if they have a visit to the doctor or a bit of local chat about, you know, who's getting married or whatever. And I came away from the place, I was so emotional.